Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is a series, Shining Stars, in which we discuss the lives of the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And today we will talk about Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu belonged to the tribe of Banu Hashim, and he was the son of Abu Talib. He was the youngest son of Abu Talib. And he was 30 years younger than the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And when Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was born, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, named him as Ali. Because Abu Talib was not financially strong, that's why the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, took the responsibility of the upbringing of Ali. And the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was good in financial conditions after his marriage with Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. And in this way, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also compensated the good which Abu Talib had done to him by bringing him up when he was an orphan. So because the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, brought Hazrat Ali up, so Hazrat Ali was very close and very much attached with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And because of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's guidance, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, remained away from all those bad practices which are very common in Mecca. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was brought up as a very good young man by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, got prophethood, and he was offering prayer with Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha at home when Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an saw him offering prayer. So he was amazed when he saw the Holy Prophet worshipping in a new way. So he asked Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, about that new way of worship. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, informed Hazrat Ali about his prophethood, and he informed him about Islam and invited him to accept Islam. But as Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was so young, so Hazrat Ali said, first I want to discuss it with my father. But Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't allow him to do that, and he said, it is a secret and I don't allow you to share it with anyone outside the house. So Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an said, I thought about it the whole night, that what should I do? But next day I went to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and said that I don't need any discussion with anyone about you, and whatever you say, I believe that you are really the messenger of Allah. And in this way, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an became the first child to accept Islam. In the second year of prophethood, when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, received the command from God, وَأَنْزِرْ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, warn your closest kinsmen towards Islam. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, arranged a feast for Banu Hashim. And after the dinner, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, invited Banu Hashim towards Islam. But Abu Lahab created the fuss, and he spoiled the whole effort of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And he opposed Islam very bluntly. But Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, who was the youngest one in this gathering, stood and he confirmed his support for Holy Prophet. And he said, though I am too young, my legs may be very thin, I am physically weak, but I say that I will be your supporter and I will fight those who will fight you. At the time, the people laughed at Ali that what this child can do for Muhammad, but Hazrat Ali proved to be a great support and a great asset of Islam in the later years. In the Meccan life, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an suffered all the difficulties and problems like all other Sahaba of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, because there was no religious freedom and the Muslims were not free to recite the Quran loudly. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an also suffered the 3 years of the boycott in Shebe Abi Talib, because he was an important member of Banu Hashim, so he was with the Holy Prophet in the valley. And it is reported that Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha used to give the pieces of gold and silver to Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an to buy food from some Meccans secretly, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an used to arrange food by giving that money to some Meccan in a lonely place. At the time of migration, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an played a very significant role, because Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an to sleep in his bed. And it was a very risky thing, because Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was going to be murdered by the Quraysh. It was their plan. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an had to sleep in his bed, covering himself in the blanket of the Holy Prophet. And besides that, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also asked him to return the valuables to the respective owners, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala carried out this responsibility, and then he migrated to Medina on foot because he did not have any means of transportation. And he joined Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in Quba. And at the time of entry in Medina, the Prophet and Abu Bakr and Hazrat Ali were all together. In Medina at the time of Mawakhat, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, made Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an the brother of Sahal bin Hunayf. Because Sahal bin Hunayf was an Ansari companion and he was also a very good sword fighter. So that was a similarity he had with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. That's why Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, paired him with Sahal bin Hunayf. But according to some reports, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was declared by the Prophet his brother. According to some reports, that when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was making the pairs between Ansar and Muhajirin, he did not make Ali anyone's brother. So Hazrat Ali asked Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that who is my brother, Ya Rasulallah? Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Ali, you don't need any brother because I am your brother. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was one of the greatest warriors, and he played significant role in all the battles fought in Medina. In the battle of Badr, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an killed Walid bin Utba in the single combat, and then he killed many other warriors because 70 Quraysh were killed in the battle of Badr, and many of them were killed by Hazrat Ali. In the battle of Uhud, the battle again started with a single combat, and seven individuals, great warriors, came from the Quraysh side one after the other, and they challenged Muslims. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, only sent Hazrat Ali, Zubair and Hazrat Hamza to fight with them. And these three great Muslim warriors killed all the seven warriors of Quraysh, and Hazrat Ali killed some of them here. And when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was attacked by Quraysh in the battle of Uhud, and a group of companions made a ring around the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, to protect him, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was one of them. And in the battle of Trench, when Amr bin Abduhu, the great warrior of Quraysh side, came across a trench and challenged Muslims for the single combat, it was only Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an who accepted his challenge, and he killed him with his famous sword, Zulfiqar. This sentence is very famous, La fata illa Aliyun wa la saifa illa Zulfiqar, that no young man can be like Ali and no sword can be like Zulfiqar. Whenever Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an had Zulfiqar in his hand, none of the warrior could stand in front of Ali, and he destroyed all of them. As Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was also a very good scribe and a very good writer, so at the time of the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, appointed him to write down the treaty. And in the Khaybar expedition, the seventh fortress, its name was Qamus, and according to some reports, its name was Nizar. When it proved to be a hard nut to crack for Muslims, and all the Muslim warriors failed to conquer it, so finally Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, tomorrow I will give the flag of my army in the hands of a person who will definitely conquer Khaybar for us. Allah loves him, and the Messenger of Allah loves him. It was such a nice thing which the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, that all the companions were eagerly waiting for the next day, that who is this fortunate person about whom Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Allah loves him and the Messenger of Allah loves him. And Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala said that I never wanted to be a leader. I never liked for that. I never waited to be appointed as a leader. But that night I was also having a wish in my heart that may the Prophet will call me tomorrow to give me this flag. But the next day the Holy Prophet called Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. But Hazrat Ali's eyes were paining because of eye infection, and because of that Ali did not participate in the previous attacks on that fort. But now Hazrat Ali had to leave. That's why Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, applied his saliva on the eyes of Hazrat Ali, and the pain vanished. It is almost the same thing which happened in the cave of Sor with Hazrat Abu Bakr, where Holy Prophet applied his saliva and the pain of Abu Bakr vanished. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and made a fierce attack on Qamus fortress. He motivated the people and he reached the gate and he forced the Jews to come out and fight. And when hand-to-hand battle took place, Muslims defeated them. And the leader of Khaybar, whose name was Mirhab, he came out from that fort and he said, I am the leader of Khaybar, the people of Khaybar call me this and that. He was praising himself and he was no doubt a great warrior. But Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala also said, Analladhi sammatni ummi Haydara, I am also the one whose mother gave him the name of Haydar. And then a combat took place between Ali and Mirhab, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala killed Mirhab with his sword Zulfiqar, and when Mirhab was killed, the Jews surrendered and Khaybar fell into the hands of Muslims. So because of this bravery and strength of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, Hazrat Ali was given the title of Asadullah, the Lion of Allah, and he was also called Haydar-e-Karrar. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an was also appointed by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, as the in charge of Medina by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, at the time of Tabuk expedition. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said to Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, that Ali, you are to me as Harun was to Musa. But Harun was a messenger and you are not a messenger, because I am the last messenger of Allah. When Hazrat Musa alayhi salam went to Mount Tur for the worship of Allah, he appointed Hazrat Harun to take care of Bani Israel. So that's why Holy Prophet said, Ali, similarly I am appointing you to take care of my people in Medina in my absence. Besides that, when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, passed away, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala got the honor to wash the body of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Hazrat Ali enshrouded him and Hazrat Ali lowered his body into the grave. So it was a great honor for Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala to carry out all these things for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala was not just a warrior. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala was also a great scholar, and he was one of the most knowledgeable of the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said about him, Ana Madinatul Ilmi wa Aliyun Babuha, I am the city of knowledge and Ali is its gate. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala was very expert in the tafsir of the Holy Quran, in the interpretation of the Holy Quran. And in the books of Tafasir, we find the sayings of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and all scattered around. He had his views about the ayat of the Holy Quran. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala said that if I would explain Suratul Fatiha to you people, so many books will be made in the tafsir of Fatiha only that you will need the camels to take the books away from here. He was so knowledgeable regarding the Holy Quran. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala narrated more than 500 ahadith of the Holy Prophet, which is a large number. The senior companions of the Holy Prophet who were busy in the politics and in administration, they did not get time to teach the people so much, but still Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala narrated more than 500 ahadith, which is a very good number. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala was a great legal expert. Many of the laws were made on the suggestion of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. Like Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala during his caliphate raised a question that what should be the punishment of drinker. Drink is haram, but the punishment is not mentioned in the Holy Quran. So Hazrat Ali suggested that the punishment of drinker should be 80 lashes, and Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala passed the law. This was the ijma of Sahaba and the law was made. And when Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala asked that we need to introduce an Islamic calendar, it was Hazrat Ali's suggestion that we should start it from Hijra. That was a turning point of the Islamic history. So the Hijra calendar was introduced from from the incident of migration. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala was so wise and intelligent that his sayings are also full of wisdom and the people quote them frequently. Hazrat Ali's sayings and his lectures, his khutbas are also compiled in a book called Nahjul Balagha, which is a source of guidance and wisdom for all the Muslims. So these are the valuable services which Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala carried out before becoming the caliph. May Allah make us follow the paths of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and we should make Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala a guide for us, and we should take benefit of the knowledge which Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala has left for all Muslims. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.